Yo guys, what's up? It's Goat the Great, and I welcome you to another episode of Driving with Goat. I haven't done one of these in a long time. It's closing in on almost a year since I've done one of these. And I've only done one episode, so I figured I'd do another simply because I really don't have the time to sit down and record a video at the time. Because as you can see, I'm driving, driving to work at that. But I wanted to kind of just discuss something really quickly here that's becoming a disturbing trend in gaming lately. And that's lazy development. I don't know what causes it. I'm not sure if it's the publisher that's tightening the noose around the necks of the developers so that they can get these games out quicker. I don't know if it's a lack of financial resources. I don't know what it is, but the development of these games is really starting to bother me. Bother me in the sense that the games are, like, they're becoming more and more unplayable. There are aspects of these games that are just almost game-breaking, or it makes the experience so unenjoyable that that particular game or that particular mode in that game is useless. It's unplayable because of the way things work or don't work, in this case, for that game. So I'll start off with this game right here, Rage. I got this game for the Xbox 360 simply because the fact that it had two discs, the fact that apparently id Software was using the Xbox 360 as its main development console, that version was supposed to be the version that ran best of the two between it and the PS3. Now, while this game doesn't have many bugs or anything like that, the game certainly is extremely broken in one aspect, and that's in its graphics. Now, I don't know if I should blame the developer id, but the fact that the graphics have such problems, I'm going to go ahead and say that they were just being a little too ambitious. It's sad, but we are at a current point in game development where the Xbox 360 and the PS3 are outdated. It's sad to say it, but they definitely are outdated. And because developer id Software was so overly ambitious, they went ahead and developed this engine that seems like it's a little bit too far, too much in the future for these consoles to handle. So you're dealing with extreme pop-ins. You're dealing with extreme texture loading, and it's a bit distracting from the overall experience as you sit there and see a plain texture all of a sudden become a detailed texture. I applaud them for what they're trying to do, but it really, like I said, it really takes away from the experience to try to imagine this beautiful, lush desert world. The frames per second ran smoothly, but I don't know. I'm at a loss here. I definitely do applaud them, but maybe they should have, as bad as it's going to sound, maybe they should have scaled things back a bit, because obviously these consoles can't handle 60 frames per second with detailed structure, with detailed textures. A lot of people are going to say the COD series is 60 frames per second, and it runs smoothly, and it doesn't have the extreme pop-in issues and texture loading issues. But you have to take into account that Call of Duty is a very plain Jane looking game. There's nothing about Call of Duty other than its frame rate that pushes any graphical boundaries. It's a very plain, very low texture game. Everything runs smoothly because they're not trying to get anything accomplished in that game as far as detail is concerned. Anyway, I'll move off of that game and I'll pop right in to this this game, Batman Arkham City. Now, the only reason why I'm showing this game is because this game, I can't think of a single thing in this game that is broken. The game runs smoothly, has great voice acting, no game-breaking bugs or glitches. And that game took a full 2 years to develop. Arkham Asylum came out August of 2009. Arkham City came out in, of course, last month? It came out October of 2011. That game is a standard by which most games should follow. Now, I'm still trying to get into the game itself, but there are no game-breaking bugs in that game. I'll show you another game that took 2 years to develop. This game right here, Uncharted Drake's Deception for the PS3. Now, that game took a full 2 years because the third one came out exactly 2 years after the second one came out. And while the single player doesn't have any game-breaking bugs, while the multiplayer doesn't have any game-breaking bugs, nor does the co-op have any game-breaking bugs, the multiplayer needs an extreme amount of work to still be done on it. It feels like they actually took a step backward with this game as opposed to Uncharted 2. Uncharted 2 seemed like it worked really well for what it was, but Uncharted 3 seems like it went backwards. I don't understand how someone that's blind firing and just running back and forth is going to have the upper hand over someone that's just aiming down the sight. I just don't understand that. And that's all that it's turned into online at this point. Everyone online is sitting there blind firing while running back and forth, and they're winning all these gunfights. A person that's aiming down the sights is not winning that gunfight. Another thing that bothers me, if you're aiming down the sight, someone that is just wildly firing can wildly fire a few shots, then leap towards you, friggin' leaping towards you like we're playing goddamn Mario Brothers, leaping towards you, and then melee you, and you're down. You're done. That's it. A few blind fire shots, then leaping Larry right into you with the goddamn gun, and you're down. What kind of horse shit is that? This makes no sense to me. In what type of gaming environment is someone allowed to freaking leap their way through gunfire and then take you out with a melee? That just makes no sense to me. This is a shooter. Why are melee attacks so overpowered compared to someone that's actually shooting? They need to fix that. And if it's not fixed, I'm sad to say that Uncharted 3's multiplayer is downright shit. I'm sorry, there's no other way to explain it. It's shit. I don't know any other way to explain it. If they fix that, then it will definitely be a lot better than it currently is. Fix it, Naughty Dog, because that game otherwise would be a great game. I don't know how the game got a 10 from IGN. IGN is probably one of the worst reviewers in the gaming industry. I don't know how that game got a 10. But with that broken-ass multiplayer, it definitely does not deserve a 10. Then, there's this game. Oh, then there is this game. Now, if I'm not mistaken, this game got a 9.0 from IGN. I didn't really look at any other reviews, but it got a 9. A 9.0. How the hell did Battlefield 3 get anything above a 7.0 or a 7.5? I would like someone to explain that to me. Because the campaign sucks dick. The campaign sucks. I'm sorry. I don't care who you are. I don't care what you say. I don't care what kind of campaigns you like or dislike. That campaign has to be one of the worst campaigns I've ever played. I think the only other campaign that I've played that's worse than that is probably Homefront. Medal of Honor's was pretty bad as well, but Battlefield's campaign is pretty bad, and I'm not done with it yet, but god damn it, it's horrible. So I don't see how the campaign could have added to the 9.0. The co-op is downright garbage. Garbage. I'm sorry, it's garbage. I thought when I played the co-op in that game that I would have been experiencing something that was almost similar to the co-op missions in Modern Warfare 2, Spec Ops. That's what I thought. I thought that they really planned this out and they had a co-op mission or co-op missions that were going to be enjoyable and just fun with a friend. Those co-op missions may as well have been excluded from the game because they're boring, they're pointless, and there's really no objective. It is the worst. It is just, they took a scenario out of the campaign, plucked you into it with a second person, and then just sends waves of enemies at you. I don't understand. It's horrible. It is downright it's disgusting. And now we segue in to the part of the game that this game should have shined in, and it does not shine. I'm sorry to say it, but it does not shine in multiplayer. And I have my reasons why I think it does not shine in multiplayer. Let's see. First of all, the game is glitched and bugged out of its ass. Let's go ahead and discuss some of the things that just make no sense in a multiplayer game. First of all, I'll start with the VoIP. If you do not have this game and you intend on buying this game, I hope to God that you have both consoles or you have the PC. Because if you have both consoles, do not, and I repeat, do not do like I did and get the PS3 version. Why? Because this game has quite possibly the worst VoIP in any game I've ever played. The voice over internet protocol being used in this game for voice chat is horrendous. It is horrible. It cuts out, it clips, it drops, it breaks. It is unusable. There were times, just last night, I was playing this with a friend of mine, and we were playing a game of Conquest. We're rushing towards Bravo. I've almost gotten to Bravo to where I can take it. Out of the blue, some ninja appears out of nowhere and knifes me in the back. And I call out to my friend, there's a guy to the left of us, because he had just spawned on me. There's a guy to the left of us, he just knifed me, he's coming towards you. Get out of there or turn around and shoot him. Seconds after he dies, he says to me, what? What did you say? Because he heard none of it. That was one of the best tactics in Battlefield Bad Company. Because you're in a squad, you can call out to your friends, you can let them know what's going on, and they can take action. If they're playing as a medic, they can revive you. That was the beauty of Battlefield. Playing in a squad, calling out, just supporting your team. Are you serious? This dude in a truck just decides that it's okay to cut up. You know what? Go fuck yourself, buddy. Anyway, back to this game. So, the VoIP is horrible. So get this on Xbox, because then you can use the excellent party chat system and you don't have to deal with in-game VoIP. I was an idiot for doing that. Another thing is some of the attachments. The tactical flashlight? Really? A tactical flashlight that blinds me when it's bright as hell during the day? I don't understand that. How the hell does that work? A flashlight and a red dot blinding me when it's freaking bright as day outside makes absolutely no sense. Also, you go down extremely fast. I don't know why these guys are trying to make their games like Call of Duty, but you go down with a couple of bullets. It's like there's no point in even having a medic or even having medic packs in this game because, well, I guess you can use the defibrillators to get your, you know, revive your friends, but there's no point in having the medic bag because you're going to go down so fast that you don't really even have a chance to regain any health. It makes no sense to me why that element was changed about Battlefield Bad Company. I think it was perfect the way that game worked, in the sense that you were able to take some gunfire, get down to cover, get some medic packs, and come back out and keep fighting the good fight. Not in this game. Not in this game. You're going down. You're dead. it's so broken. Another aspect is the squad matchups. You will start a squad with four friends, everyone joins, and then the game throws you into a server that only has room for two people on one team and one person on the other. So what does it do? It takes your squad and it breaks your squad up. What's the point in having squads if you're going to split my squad up? Then you can't hear your friend. They're on the other team. They can't connect to you. So you try to connect to them and the game says something like, switching teams is going to make the game, make the server unbalanced. Why the hell is the team switch option in there if it's going to unbalance the server? It just makes no sense. And then when the team switch option does work, it doesn't rejoin you into the squad. So you're in the position of now having to send another invite to your friend or going into the join session option just to join your friend as a squad again. It's a broken multiplayer experience. This is a horrible game. I don't know how I even thought that DICE would have improved much from the beta. I'm sorry, I don't care if the beta was 100 builds away from the final product. This isn't much different from the beta. This is a horrible game. At the best, this game deserves a 6.5, maybe a 7.0. It's a horrible game. The multiplayer is broken. The VoIP is broken. The squads are broken. It's a shitty game. And I'm sad to say it, but I expected this game to be a better multiplayer experience than Modern Warfare 3, and it's not happening. Modern Warfare 3, as repetitive and as redundant as that gameplay has become, it's going to be a better product than this overall. I'm sick of this crappy development that we have to deal with. These guys are putting no effort into developing their games, and they're handing us a bunch of horseshit for our money. I'm done. I'm at work. This is Goat the Great. This has been Driving with Goat Episode 2. Let me know what you guys think. If you want to flame me in the comments, go ahead. If you want to agree with me, go ahead. I'd be happy to hear it. I'll speak to you guys later, and have a great day. Peace.